Zip FM.
Aš jau esu čia studijoje pas mus 313 Cable Park'e Žybininkose prie Palangos. Nebe vienas, aš šalia savęs turiu, na, tikrai nedažnai galiu pristatyti tokį žmogų su tiek daug titulų. Nick Davis 4 kartus pasaulio čempiono veikbordinimo, 2 kartus pasaulio taurės laimėtoje, bei taipogi 2 Gineso rekordų, kaip, turėtoje, holderį galima, taip tikriausiai sakyti. Yeah, it's working. So, Nick Davis, welcome to Zip FM studio. Very nice to have you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, man. I've just introduced all your titles and shit, and I cannot start without asking you this first. How come Guinness records? I understand you're very good at wakeboarding. Yeah, you won the championship. You won the World
Speaking
Cup.
Highly.
But what's about the Guinness record? Okay, so was it drinking bet? Have you climbed the mountain? Have you been juggling?
It wasn't a drinking bet, but no? I probably could be a good contender for this. But no, it was wakeboarding based. About 4 years ago, I got the opportunity to have a Guinness World Record attempt through one of my sponsors in the UK. And I took that day. I got 2 Guinness World Records, most flips in 1 minute, and 6 backflips in continuous. So
wow. Yeah. That was all in 1 minute.
All in 1 minute, yeah. 26 flips.
Wow. Paklausiau Niko, sakau, kaip čia yra, kad tu laimėjai pasaulio čempionatus, aš suprantu, pasaulio taurę, aš suprantu, bet prieš kur tie Gineso rekordai? Tai sakė, kad kadangi jį sponsoriai labai myli, kažkokį suorganizavo eventą ir ten jam buvo galimybė per vieną minutę padaryti kuo daugiau vadinamųjų flipų, na, apsisukti plaukiant vandenlentę. So, Nick, I'm gonna ask you not only today about wakeboarding, but I'm just interested in general because, you know, how is life as a pro athlete? Because I can tell you you're a pro athlete, right?
I would like to say this. Yeah, no, it's amazing. I'm a very lucky boy. I've been wakeboarding now for 15 years. I get to travel the world doing something I love. I get to come places like this. I get to do things like this, which is awesome. And it's all because of wakeboarding. So, yeah, lucky boy.
Wow. Nikas sako, kad visiškai yra labai netikėtinai patenkintas savo gyvenimu. Jau 15 metų jis gali užsiimti tuo, ką labai labai mėgsta. Keliauti po pasaulį, atkeliauti į tokias vietas, kaip at mes čia dabar gyvename, 313 Cable Park'e. Na, ir tikrai bišas labai yra dėkingas už tai, kad gali gyventi ir va tokį įdomų ir nuotykingą gyvenimą. Listen, wakeboarding, yeah? In general. When was it born? Why was it born? Was it because then other boarders were angry, were tired of waiting for wind? How did it all begin? Tell me, because I have a feeling you actually started when it all started up. No?
Wakeboarding, as I said, I've been doing it about 15, 16 years now, but wakeboarding come around, I think, 25 years ago.
25 years.
Behind the boat. It was mostly behind the boat, but now it's crossed over to the cable scene, which is where we're at 313 today.
Also, it's actually the same sport. Technically, it's the same sport, which with the thing when you are tied to the boat.
Exactly. Same sport. It's just a different approach, different way of doing it. On the cable, you can get more people on at once. On the boat, it's just one rider. Use the wake to do your tricks. On the cable, you use the obstacles.
Yeah. Nikas sako, kad šiaip wakeboardingas kaip sportas atsirado panašiai prieš 25 metus ir visą tai prasidėjo daugiausiai, na, kai žmonės tampydavo tiesiog laivais. Vėliau viskas perėjo prie šitos vadinamosios cable, kabelių sistemos, kuomet daugiau žmonių gali vienu metu mėgautis šituo dalyku, o ne tiesiog vienas žmogus temptis paskui pabaigą. I know also one this thing about you in Lithuania. You have this fun relationship. You've been around here many times, haven't you?
I've been here a lot and I'm still coming here a few times a year. I love coming to this place. 313 now, the new wake park here is amazing, so I'll be coming a lot more.
Wow. Nikas iš tikrųjų dažnai atvyksta į Lietuvą, mes čia jau kavinėje prieš tai vakare kalbėjomės, kad jis tikrai nebe pirmą kartą čia yra ir sako, kad jam tikrai čia labai patinka. How can you answer me this question? Because I have a feeling, I don't know, maybe it's just because of my friends who love this sport, but I see it a lot. Why do you think in Lithuania this sport as wakeboarding kicked off so good? I mean, was it the people, was it the conditions, was it the lakes, or was it just the passion for sport?
The passion, I can see the passion over here is huge. Such a wakeboarding has been around, I think, 4 or 5 years since I've been coming here, and in this time it's grown so much. All the riders are really involved, the shops, board sports, everyone is really pushing the sport over here, and it's great to see.
Taip, Nikas sako, kad iš tiesų mano, kad didžiausia priežastis, dėl ko Lietuvoje taip sportas, veikbordinimas apskritai išsiplėtojo ir taip jam puikiai sekasi, yra tiesiog žmonių, kurie tai užsiema, žmonių, kurie tai plėtoja aistra šitam dalykui, tiek parduotuvės, tiek patys parkai, tiek infrastruktūra, tiek patys raideriai, tiek patys žmonės, kurie čiuožia, sako, tikrai per 4-5 metus, kiek iš čia atvyksta, tikrai mato jisai didžiulį pasikeitimą ir tikrai didžiulį tobulėjimą.
also, I'm gonna ask you this one last question, and we're gonna have a little break, and then okay. we're gonna come back.
Cool. Draugai, kas norite šiaip paklausti, ko nors, jeigu netyčia pačio geriausio, vieno geriausio pasaulio raiderio, kokio nors klausimo, ir patys to užsiemate, arba turit kokio nors techninių galbūt klausimų, nedvėjokite, parašykite man į mano laidos Facebook'o paskyrą apie titas brūkšnelį ZipFM. And this one last question before this little break, yeah? How did you, were you doing something else with boards, I mean, sport-wise, before you started wakeboarding? Or was it just you woke up one day and you said, I'm going to be a wakeboarder? Or have you been an athlete with some other subjects?
No, I've got three older brothers and we've all been into sports. They all do motocross.
Motocross.
So we've all been on the bike since a young age. But then I crossed over to skateboarding. And I used to do a lot of skateboarding as a hobby in school. And then through one of my school friends, he did wakeboarding. I got introduced with him. And here I am, ever since.
Taip, jis sako, kad prieš pradėdamas savo wakeboarderio karjerą, jis turėjo su savo broliais labai aktyviai užsiminėdavo motocrosso sportu, vėliau jis perėjo prie skateboardinimo ir po to dabar jau mes va, turim, ką turim, profesionalų vieną geriausių pasaulyje raiderių. Taigi, draugai, aš čia studijoje turiu Nicką Davisą, 4 kartus pasaulio wakeboardinimo čempioną. Jeigu norite jo kažko paklausti, nedvėjokite parašyti man į mano laidos Facebook'o paskyrą apie titas brūkšnelis ZipFM. O šiaip tai visai netrukus mes dar grįšime ir pakalbėsime apie boards. Sports Salt Fest, kur jūs, jeigu norėsite, pavyzdžiui, kitą savaitę, čia vat ne kitą, dar kitą savaitę, nusišneku, Liepos 22-29 dienomis, čia 313 Cable Park'e vyks didžiulis festivalis, kur jūs taipogi galėsite sutikti Nicką. You're gonna be an instructor at this...
I will be there coaching, helping out if anyone wants to ride and learn some new tricks. Taip. Or just have some fun for the week.
Taip. Pas mane šiandien studijoje yra labai fainas svečias, toksai labai tituluotas svečias, 4 kartus pasaulio wakeboardinimo čempionas, Nick Davis, na, ne tik ten ir to čempionas, ir pasaulio Guinness rekordų holderis. Žodžiu, Nick, nice to have you here, say again.
Thank you, thanks for having me.
Yeah, so some other people haven't heard, you know, our start of our conversation, okay. So I was just saying that all those, I was just explaining them that there are some rumors, at least in this park, in 313 Cable Park, that the reason, you're coming to Lithuania so often is that you are looking for a Lithuanian wife.
I don't know what these rumors are, but no, they are false.
They are false.
They are very false. I come here to look for great wakeboard friends, and that's it. No Lithuanian wife.
Niko paklausiau, sako, kad čia žmonės bent jau parke kalba, kad viena iš priežasčių, kodėl jis taip dažnai atvyksta į Lietuvą, sakau, yra, kad jis lietuvės žmonos ieško. Tai jisai jos paneigė, sakė, ne, jisai čia tiesiog ieško savo wakeboardinimo draugų, o žmonos jisai kažkaip, na, bent jau kol kas lietuvės neplanuoja. Okay, you were saying before that, you know, one of the greatest things about your work and everything is that you get to travel around the world.
Correct.
And, do you have this one particular, for example, crazy story about your travels, and I think there should be one. I don't know, you went to some country and you were expecting one and you get completely different one, or you had to sleep in a hotel with somebody, or something crazy, something stupid, or is everything in wakeboarding according to the book and everything goes
That's a hard question, to be fair. As I said, I've been in a lot of places, lucky enough to go and travel to, but they're all good for different reasons. Stories, some you can say, some you can't. But you know, I have fun everywhere I go. That's why I get invited to places, try to enjoy what I do and let everyone have fun as well, and yeah, stories flow with that.
Nika sako, kad kažkokių tokių crazy istorijų vienos labai tikras neprisimena, kadangi jis yra labai daug jau kur pasaulį apkeliavęs ir negalėjo atsakyti, kokia yra keiščiausia ir pati tokia istorija, kurią galėtų vieną čia išskirti iš visų savo kelionių. About this room of yours, is it true that you have your own suite here in 313?
This is very true. I'm actually not in there at the moment. I'm staying here, but I'm in my friend's room because my room's booked out, which is great, but I would like to sleep in there as well at some stage. But yeah, very lucky. The guys here gave me my own signature room, which is awesome. Never had this in ever, so... Very lucky boy.
It sounds very nice. Yeah. Jo, Hebra čia, 313 parke, taip mėgsta Nicką, taip vat, norėjo jį pamaloninti, kad netgi vienas iš namukų, kurį čia galima išsinuomoti, yra grinai jo vardo namukas. Ir būtent dabar sako, negali jame gyventi, nes kažkas yra užsibukinęs, bet kada nors norėtų netrukus artimiausiu metu ten grįžti. Also... This festival, of which is happening next week, we need to talk about that because we need to invite people who probably... Is it designed for guys who has already tried and are very good level? Or if I've never tried wakeboarding?
If you've never tried, if you're new to the sport or new to any board sports at all, just come. It's going to be an amazing festival. If you just want to come and party, have fun, dance, listen to great music, you know, this is going to be the festival for that. If you want to come and try wakeboarding, a bit of skateboarding, kiteboarding, come... feel free, come down, we'll be here to help.
Wow. Tai kaip jau tikriausiai supratote, ką aš jau užminėjau praėjusiame savo išėjime, Board Sports komanda Liepos 22-29 būtent organizuoja čia 313 Cable Park'e didžiulį boardinimo festivalį. Tai čia bus apimtos visos įmanomos, man atrodo, kokios dabar yra įmanoma rūšis. Bus ne tik wakeboardinimas, bus ir kažkokios kitos sporto rūšis. Žodžiu, jeigu nepaisant to, kad esi visiškai naujas, nesi niekada net bandęs jokio sporto, bet nori pabandyti, tikrai verta susirasti šitą informaciją internete. Facebook'e labai nesunkiai rasite Board Sports Salt Fest ir tikrai prie mūsų visų prisijungti. So, one last thing, message to all your Lithuanian fans, which I probably know you have plenty, or just a message for our listeners, because we're broadcast to all over the world, okay. Actually. You
well,
know, there
really.
Are definitely people who are Lithuanians
well,
who are listening to our now somewhere
well,
in California.
If you're listening,
California.
Thank you for listening to my boring voice. It's an absolute pleasure to be coming on here today, speaking to you guys. Yeah, I'm very lucky, as I said. I'm here, 313 Wake Park in Lithuania. If you feel like you want to come try wakeboarding, come and have fun.
Taip, Nikas dar kartelį tiesiog visus pakvietė, kad jeigu, dar kartelį paminėjo tai ir pabrėžė, kad jeigu jūs tiesiog norite išbandyti šitą sportą, arba tiesiog atvykti ir patobulinti savo įgūdžius, Nikas yra čia ir laukia jūsų, atvarykit ir susipažinkit su ne šiaip bet kuo, o 4 kartus pasaulio čempionų. So, Nick, thank you very much
thank
for
you.
Coming today.
No,
it
really
was a pleasure,
it.
A very interesting interview, really, man, yep. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Good luck with your wife searches and all that stuff.
Oh, no.